बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। ओके स्टूडेंट्स एंड टीचर्स एंड पेरेंट्स, प्रीवियसली वी हैव डन आर फर्स्ट टू और थ्री पेजेस ऑफ आवर चैप्टर ऑफ न्यू ऑक्सफोर्ड सोशल स्टडीज फॉर पाकिस्तान फॉर क्लास फाइव। एज यू कैन सी हियर, दिस इज़ द बुक टाइटल and we were reading our lesson number 3, that is life in desert and forest regions, and we have done its page number 15, 16, 17 and 18 and 19 half page. Today we are going to start our page number 19, and from here you have to start from here forest. Now pay attention on your books. At one time many parts of the earth were covered by thick forests, but only a few forests remain today. One of the reasons is that the world's population has multiplied many times over. More space is needed for homes, farms, factories and roads. On the map below, you can see the two main forest regions of the world. Here they are saying that why the forests are vanishing from the surface of the earth, because of the increase in population, peak of population, all the land which was cultivated and which was covered with the forest, now it is covered with the buildings and roads and factories and homes and farms, all these things. So that's why the forests are being cut, and they are instead used for building the roads and factories, etc. On the map below, in this map, you can see the two main forest regions of the world. Here, this thing is saying, this key is telling us this light green color is about equatorial forest, means the forests which are near to the equator. Here, this is the equator, and all the equatorial forests are colored in this light green color, as you can see here. And all the temperate forests means which are near the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, they are colored in dark green colors. Okay, these are two different types of forests. These are equatorial forests near to the equator, and these are temperate forests which are near to the Arctic Circle. So you will notice the equatorial forests are close to the equator, spreading north and south of it to the tropics, while most of the temperate forests lie between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle in the northern hemisphere. Here, as I have told you already, that these are equatorial forests are near to the equator, and temperate forests are near to the Arctic and Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Here you can see here. Now move to the next page, page number 20. Equatorial forests. Equatorial forests, also known as tropical rainforests, are found in South American countries of Ecuador, Colombia and Brazil. In the African countries of Liberia, the Ivory Coast, Ghana, Togo, Benin, Nigeria, Cameroon, Equatorial Guinea, the Congo and the Democratic Republic of Congo, and in the Southeast Asian countries of Indonesia, Myanmar, Burma and Malaysia. Here they are telling us about the equatorial forests, that which are the regions of the world in which the equatorial forests are found. These are the regions, here you can see in this paragraph, these are all the regions of the world. These are the places where you can find the equatorial forests. South American countries of Ecuador, Colombia, Brazil, African countries of Liberia, Ivory Coast, Ghana, Togo, Benin, Nigeria, Cameroon, Equatorial Guinea, the Congo and the Democratic Republic of Congo. These regions are also called hot wetlands. The temperatures here are very high, and there is a great amount of rainfall. Some of these countries were once completely covered by thick forests. These regions are called hot wetlands. Hot means their climate is really hot, but they also have heavy rainfalls, so they are called hot wetlands. Temperatures here are very high, means these are very hot places, and there is a great amount of rainfall. Some of these countries were once completely covered by thick forests. The equatorial region receives a lot of sunshine and is therefore very hot. When there is bright sunshine, the earth heats up and so does the water. The water evaporates and forms clouds and then it rains. Here they are saying that equatorial region receives a lot of sunshine because the countries which lie near the equator, here this is the equator, these the countries which are near the equator are very hot, so their temperature is very hot and they receive a lot of sunshine from the sun, and that's why the water also gets very hot and it evaporates and forms thick clouds, and that's why a heavy rainfall is seen in these forests, in equatorial forests. In the equatorial forest, the average rainfall in a year is 200 to 250 centimeters. It is a very high amount of rainfall. The Amazon rainforest is in Brazil is still the world's largest rainforest. In most of the English movies, in most of the Hollywood movies, whenever there is a forest shown in the movie, that is mainly one of these hot wetland forests of Amazon or Colombia or these kind of forests. They usually film their movies in these forests because these are very thick forests. The Amazon rainforest in Brazil is still the world's largest rainforest. These forests are very important as they are a source of oxygen for all living things and are known as the lungs of the earth. Brazil has the largest rainforest known as Amazon rainforest in the world, and they have too much greenery that is needed to produce oxygen for the whole world. That's why they are known as the lungs of the earth. Amazon island is known as the lungs of the earth. The heavy rainfall and fertile soil make it possible for plants to grow quickly. Here the in Amazon and in these rainforests, the soil is very fertile, so many plants grow here and they grow very quickly. There are some plants that grow 15 centimeters in a day. The forests are thick and lush, the tall trees forming a canopy high above the ground. Canopy means they form this kind of cover with their because the trees are very tall, and when they grow upwards, they combine with each other like this and they form a thick canopy. The forests are so thick that when a tree dies or is chopped down, it does not crash to the ground. It merely rests against the other trees close by. The equatorial forests are rich in medicinal plants. Means here the plants or trees are too much thick and too much close to each other, that if one plant dies or it is or if it is cut down, when it will fall, it will not fall on the ground, except it will fall on other trees like this, it will, because they all are so much close to each other. And the plants of this region is have very rich medicinal properties, means most of the medicines, many of the medicines are made from the extracts of these plants found in these regions. The great variety of trees and thick undergrowth provide animals with good homes. There are millions of small insects in these forests. In fact, there are so many different species that many have not even been named. Birds and larger animals also love these forests. Some of the birds are very colorful. Some of the large animals include leopards, elephants, hippopotamuses, and wild buffaloes. There are also crocodiles and plenty of snakes, and of course there is a variety of monkeys. They are telling us about the animals and insects of these equatorial forests. As you can see here, that here it is a monkey, it is a snake, it is a bird, and it is a frog. All these animals and thousands of other animals are found in these equatorial forests. The people of the equatorial forests are usually tribal, means they are divided into different tribes, jinko hum kabile kehte hain. In the Central African rainforest, there are pygmies, who are very short, dark people. In the South American and Asian forests, there are other tribes. All these people are very good hunters because of dense vegetation. Vegetation means plantation. It is difficult to travel through these forests. The people who live there also have great difficulty in clearing land for cultivation. So this was about the equatorial forest. It means equatorial forests are very much thick, and they have a great number of plants in them, and they the temperature of these forests is very hot, but these forests also receive a heavy rainfall because of the hot temperature. The soil is very fertile here, and too many plants grow here, and they grow very quickly here, and some of the plants can even grow 15 centimeters long in a day. And the forests are so thick here that when a plant is chopped down or when it dies, it does not fall onto the ground, except it falls, it merely lies on top of the other trees. All these plants of these forests, they have rich medicinal properties, and a lot of variety of different animals and birds and insects is found in these forests, because as these forests are very thick, so they provide a very good shelter, a very good home for all kinds of animals, insects and birds, etc. Some of the large animals include leopards, elephants, hippopotamuses and wild buffaloes, etc. Crocodiles and snakes and monkeys are also found here. And most of the people which live here, they are found in the form of different tribes. And because of lot of the plants here, because of thick forests here, the land is not clear for vegetation. So it is very difficult to travel through these forests, and it is also very difficult to plant or cultivate other crops here. So it was all about equatorial forests. In next lesson, we will read about temperate forests. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.